welcome to another episode of Tanmay React. Today we have with us Rohan Joshi and Ashish Shakya, two people you have never seen around me. What a surprise. Who knows, have we ever done any content together?
Who are you?
Friends, today we are watching a show called Drive to Survive. Have you seen Drive to Survive?
Every episode. It's too good.
Why?
So F1 mein ek cheez hoti thi. Like they would always just focus on पहली तीन गाड़ियां कौन है, right? तो सबको पता है Schumacher कौन है, सबको पता है Hamilton कौन है, और मतलब ऐसा दो तीन चीज सबको पता है. Beyond that, the other 16 cars nobody gave a shit about, right?
Correct.
Then comes Drive to Survive, where the title actually was literally, if you go see the first season, you don't see any of the cars who are in the front of the grid.
It is literally correct.
About sixth onwards, because these are people who are literally driving for their place to even be in the season next year.
Are you saying they're literally driving to survive?
It's crazy.
What
I know.
Crazy. Concept.
Whoever was in charge of naming the show should get a raise.
Yes. If you don't watch Formula One also, you will love this show, because the show is not about Formula One.
No.
It's about the people who are driving and their life stories.
100%.
Dude, it is like every episode is like a mini thrilling movie.
How do you sum up your season?
It's one short word. Shit. What a
mess. Gunter Steiner.
Gunter ke liye kaun sa season shit nahi hai. Haas chala raha hai bechara.
So two people very interesting on the show. Gunter Steiner and Daniel Ricciardo. Aur pehle season ke pehle episode se sabse zyada style aur attitude ye dono de rahe. Sabse ghatiya career in dono ka chal raha hai. Theek hai?
It's only because of Gunter Steiner that I know the German words for MCBC and all that.
I feel like I'm only just getting started.
Shut the fuck up. How many times do I have to say this shit?
Like these people are like the elitists of the elite, lekin dil se sab log chindi. Dil se sab log comedian green room. Like this just heavy.
Okay, so give me some basic rivalry.
Basic rivalries, one is the biggest one is of course Verstappen Hamilton, right? The added context there is there are two teams. Mercedes has now won 7 times in a row. Now Lewis Hamilton, one of the greatest drivers that ever lived. Which is also part of the reason why not a lot of people like it. Because he's made winning boring.
That's what I don't understand. Like, I get it theoretically, but it's very weird to see the other side of the fan base saying he's you for being too good.
Sorry,
inka dusra ye bhi hai against Hamilton ki. Yeah, iska to gaadi mast hai. Driver theek hai, but he wins because gaadi mast hai, paisa dalte hai. Mere ko ye gaadi de, main bhi bond. That's the other thing.
And the other rivalries, what's interesting in Formula One is that you get lower down the order, the rivalries are less between two teams and more between two drivers in one team. So one interesting one this year, for example, is the McLaren team. So they've got Lando Norris and they've got Daniel Ricciardo. Lando Norris is like this young driver. Like, but there's a very interesting rivalry between the two of them because they're both very like fun-loving, chill guys. And everybody thought they would get along. But Norris consistently sort of outperformed him over the course of the season.
Oh.
Right. So like Ricciardo ka narrative became, ka, has this guy lost it? So then that becomes a thing.
My name is Yuki Tsunoda.
Mick Schumacher.
Nikita Mazepin. Haas F1 team.
By the way, this is a very interesting, at some point, look into the rivalry. There's a Haas that basically Gunter Steiner's team. Woh aadmi exam mein kuch bhi karega, ye last aayega.
Can you do it in Russian as well?
Nikita Mazepin. Haas F1 team.
Isme Russian kya tha?
He just said his name slightly different.
Mercedes will always go into a season as the favorite. But having won the title for 7 years in a row, there has to come a point at which that ends. I shouldn't say that with such a smile on my face.
See, everyone dislike. Everyone dislike for no reason.
Everyone is like, band karo ye Mercedes.
But Mercedes walon ko bhi lagta hoga ki yaar, chal is bar Haas ko jeetne dete. Just for fun, jeez. Ek bar.
Uski naam hai, uski Haas hai.
Haasi to phasi.
Last year was a difficult season. Now,
देखा ये सब attitude करके last.
All right, first race.
Qualifying is everything in Formula One because it determines your starting position on the grid on Sunday. You want to start from the front. Because it means you've got the other 19 drivers starting behind you.
It's a speed test. Good explanation of how
Yeah.
Thank you.
You can make anything sound deep.
I think this is how Netflix knows that they're getting new audiences. They're like, please describe race. No, no, uske pehle kya hota hai? We'll go round.
Like, what do you want really him to say, like, race saaso ki, race dhadkan ki, race baho ki?
I would appreciate it. Tab Vijay Mallya tha, tab ye ho sakta tha.
He's a fierce, fierce competitor, and he's got nothing to lose.
Beat him.
And Verstappen sets the fastest time.
Oh!
He sent the Red Bull garage into raptures.
Oh!
The prodigy
is at number one.
But you see how immediately we got like into it.
Yeah.
But what I like is, I've always thought this. Inka team audio suna hai na tumne jo wo radio pe jo risk kiya.
Bahut fun bhi aata hai.
But kitna kaam hai. Like how can you be so
good? Aur bhi yelling the whole time. Mere pad rahi hai. Bahut is.
I just turn.
Sammy, you will break.
I feel like there are bits that they edit out that they don't show us.
They are obviously not keeping the part where like honors on the day. A pen fast chala. Like they're not showing it.
How long do you think this is gonna be? Yeah,
it's just two questions to Toto, and then we will come to you here. Okay.
Thanks. Great.
Fuck it, we've just got to keep the smile off his face, huh?
Wow! What a thing to say, right?
Yep.
Wow.
Like, yep.
It's amazing that they captured all this, right?
Arre, dude, this is very hardcore.
Fourth season, so the team, the drivers, everyone is like, ab kya hai? Sun le, pura sun le Netflix. Mere ghar ke andar aake baitha.
Basically, Netflix inka vlog banata.
Okay, so qualifying is done.
The important thing to remember is Verstappen is on pole and Hamilton is behind him.
Correct. Okay, Verstappen got out of corner, still in full position. Yep. Oh!
That's Gunter Steiner's car. I would like to point out three corners, first lap.
Always.
For guys who came on camera and did this. Uska pehla gaadi pehle lap pe teen corner pe gaya.
Verstappen's got fresh tyres. Hamilton takes the lead of the Grand Prix though.
Hamilton,
the longer he stays on the older tire, he'll seed more ground per lap also as the tires start to fade.
Dude, a lot of the race winning and the planning literally comes down to hum kab tire change.
One decision can wipe out any gains you've made earlier or like give you fresh gains out of nowhere.
Box. Okay.
Lewis Hamilton box means come into the pits.
Into the pits comes Lewis Hamilton. That's a really interesting strategy call.
Probably it'll be like interesting meaning what the
bol raha hai, stop way too early, man. Not gonna make it to the end. Basically, he might have to do two pit stops. Means Verstappen could win.
To either two pit stops, or even if he keeps it on a one pit stop, he'll have to be on slightly older tires towards the end. Like his end laps.
What will Red Bull do here? Will they change tires now or stay out?
Oh.
28 laps remaining.
It's like chess at 300 kilometers an hour.
Yeah.
True blitz chess. True blitz.
Formula One is like a game of chess.
Ah! Oh! Ashish Horner.
Verstappen's tires are wearing. Red Bull, now make a move to change.
Okay, so now the question is, will Verstappen come out ahead of Hamilton or not?
Or even if he comes out behind him, will he catch up?
It's that.
Hamilton is back in the lead of the race, but Verstappen has fresher, faster tyres now.
And Verstappen 3.1 behind.
No. Maybe 2.
And he's locked up into 10, he's gone wide.
Is exactly what Red Bull would want to see. Hamilton is starting to really struggle out there.
Dude, I love that we get to hear the comms because the team has just told him he's 10 seconds piche hai, sambhal ke.
Yep.
And he's like, don't worry, I got it.
And then
Hamilton's gonna force Verstappen the long way round. By the time they get to the corner, he's a third of the car.
nobody went out.
It's a whole car in front.
Oh, he went to Hamilton.
He went all the way around the outside of Hamilton.
Wow. What happened?
I stopped watching the race because at one point I saw Tanmay just genuinely got his hand here. And he's watching. His hand is just here and he's watching.
Oh, so good.
So we're taking the outside. The track.
Copy loose, we'll look into that.
Oh, he overtook him outside the track. That is technically not right.
Look, he took the position off the track there, Verstappen.
Let Lewis through.
Just let me go, man.
Yeah, we had the instruction from race control, unfortunately, Max.
It's 1 inch too deep into a corner. But it's the fine margin that win or lose races.
Oh, he's gonna lose.
Hamilton is weaving around, doing everything
Lewis
possible.
Lewis still has the older tires, right?
Yeah.
Lewis still has the older tires.
When you have Lewis Hamilton in the car, we know that he has the skill and the determination to overcome whatever strategy they've thrown at us.
Oh, he won!
This is why I submit that it's not just the car.
Yeah, exactly.
Not just the car. He, despite having older tires, still somehow held on.
That's driver skill, dude. That is just unbeatable driver skill.
But wow.
I would like to point out this is first race of the season.
Yeah. I can't wait to see the second race. Let's just get into the second race. Okay, so episode 2 is about McLaren. And McLaren mein do driver hai. Ricardo, jiska thoda crypto portfolio type career chal raha hai abhi.
Lekin phir bhi senior hai.
Senior. Aur uska naya partner Lando Norris.
Daniel Ricciardo.
Dude, the internet has the perfect word to describe Daniel Ricciardo. He's a Chad.
He's a Chad.
He's a giga Chad. Like in this show, it's literally like there are times where the camera goes to him on a normal day. You can assume that he's doing Chad giri. Also, one of their big drivers from last season, Carlos Sainz, moved up to Ferrari.
Correct.
And then they got Ricciardo. So it's little like, fuck, chalega, nahi chale. And the problem is they came third last year. So because there are financial implications as your spots fall.
So pressure Ricciardo pe.
Haan, pressure Ricciardo pe and Zach Brown, who's the team principal, us pe bhi hai.
So kya Ricciardo ki chaddi right ho gayi hai?
Exactly. Aha.
Bunt to survive.
Aap to haas ya kavi ho. Aur ye Ricciardo.
So ye Ricciardo hai. Haan. This is Ricciardo. Aur ye Lando hai.
Haan.
I put a tremendous amount of pressure on. Sorry,
but like, Lando bolte mere man mein thoda giggling hota hai.
It feels like censor word agar ye episode dekho le kya bola
acha
aur inki rivalry hai to matlab one is saying to the other na aana is this Lando.
Zach Brown superstar signing Daniel Ricciardo.
Okay,
never been out qualified
by a way to set someone up to fail.
Yeah.
All eyes on no pressure guy who was only worth all the money on hopes are riding. Miss you, love you, your parents will be disappointed. No pressure.
Will Ricciardo beat Norris in his first outing in the McLaren?
Does he?
He does.
Okay.
Well done, guys.
So basically, Chad came and like beat Lando.
In qualifying.
Do you want me to say
from
now on? Oh,
mate.
Yeah,
shit, Lando.
I was
going to
do that.
Yeah, I thought
you say that.
Meanwhile, presenting to you Lord Chagsworth of Chagtown.
100% Ricciardo is that guy who was born in London. Like, he's that. 100%.
Oh, race day. Okay, let's see what happens.
The two McLarens battling each other and not the opposition.
Norris is now going to challenge him all the way up to turn 4.
Overtake Mafia.
Yep.
Nice job.
ये लोग ताले क्यों बजा रहा है
no, that's the thing. This is the other interesting thing about F1 team dynamics. Lando will have his own race manager and his own pit crew. So within that also, you're loyal to your boy, right? Because you're the one who's setting up your boy's car and you're the one who's managing your boy's race. So within that, it's like, added dynamic होता है F1.
तो Lando was behind Ricciardo And Lando's overtaken now.
Yeah.
This is plan A, maximum pace.
Oh. Yeah.
And the McLaren breezes past the Ferrari.
Oh.
Ricardo kidhar hai? Ricardo be like, should I spend more time in car and less with Mike?
Two tons slower than Lando.
दिख रहा है कि वो आगे है, दिख रहा है आगे ही गाड़ी है, ऑरेंज है, ऑरेंज है रात में, ठीक है.
Lando Norris finishes fourth, scoring big points for McLaren.
On the pace, huh?
Look, it's impossible to judge a new driver on the first race at the start of a new season.
But Ricardo kind of sucks. Oh, poor thing. Imola.
Daniel, car behind is now Lando.
Yep.
वापस दोनों का चल रहा
है. I have a lot more pace to beat. Daniel, we have to swap positions. We need to see Lando's pace in clear air.
That's a very humiliating thing to be told. What your team is basically saying is, "Hut ja, bachcha thoda aur fast ja raha hai, usse jaane de." And this is not even like a clear Hamilton Bottas situation. I think this is between two equals. You're making a judgment call where you're like, "Bro, I'm really sorry. You're just slowing your teammate down. Fucking get out of the way." Which gotta hurt for an F1 driver whose only job it is to be the fastest person.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh.
P16.
Okay, so Daniel Ricciardo is not doing well in this season so far.
Yes.
Even though he's a Chad, still got a feel, man.
Of course, Chads have feelings too, right?
I don't know what the fandom around Ricciardo is. Joshi, you probably know better, but he's kind of like likable, dude.
Yeah, he's very likable. And he's a very fan favorite. Like, if you go to his Instagram, he makes a reel, time pass, jump, he's a lot of Chad.
To work, right?
Oh, tough one.
Why are you here in this appointment? Shapes what type of person you are, yeah? What if I'm just a cunt?
So Chad funny. Has spoken.
And he's not being funny. Like, this no. is his genuine emotion.
He's literally, yeah. This is how he expresses his feelings.
His name should have been Foster's because of how Australian he is.
Thing when talking about Daniel and me feeling sorry.
Okay,
for
so this is important context. Just before this race, if I'm not mistaken, McLaren has essentially announced that Lando has been given a multi-year contract extension. And in the middle of that, he's also basically, Lando's been asked in an interview, etc., whatever, at which point he's gone and said something to the effect of, it's not my job to feel sorry for Daniel. Which is not wrong.
But like,
but now obviously... So ye ho gaya hai.
The bits I want to cover off are this bullshit that came up about Lando's sympathy piece. So I'm just conscious that someone might have a go to sort of try and dig in there. Not either anyone's job to feel sorry for anybody. Basically, we're here to get on with our jobs and...
Unless you want me to feel some sympathy for you.
Not really.
Oh, wow.
So I think Lando bhi kafi ungal.
Don't honest.
Close my eyes and recall pretty much everything.
Daniel Ricciardo leading the Monaco Grand Prix. Different shoot.
Daniel, he's a phenomenal driver. That Monaco victory in 2018. It was the most amazing race. All his wins were big wins. They were big drive.
I know what I'm capable of around here, so I just want to live up to that. Okay. I want to do that this weekend.
Yeah. See more Chadness.
Q.
Because Ricardo lives his life by one principle. When in doubt, Chad.
Okay, so Ricardo needs to win Monaco and he has won there in 2018. So this might be
his story.
Daniel Ricciardo has had a particularly poor start.
He's tumbling down the field.
Lando lag gay. Lando lag gay.
Okay, Daniel, let's go now. Let's start picking up the pace.
I'm just struggling more and more, so I think I'm only going to get slower.
That's extremely bad news.
We are P2. What's happening behind?
Norris behind.
Daniel Bicciaro. Oh no!
Yeah.
He's gonna lap Daniel.
Wait for it.
Oh my god!
Like...
Car in front is now Daniel.
Yeah, confirm. Shortly, you'll get blue flags for Lando.
Yep. Just let me know where. I'll let him go.
And Ricardo is getting the blue flags. He now has to allow Norris to lap him.
Waving to Daniel Ricciardo.
Wow. Why?
I don't know.
The teammates.
No reason to do that. Unnecessary ungal.
Ooh, most max.
Yeah. What a day for Ferrari. They can celebrate as Carlos Sainz second place.
Pito, Carlos Pito.
And Norris comes home to take third and another podium.
P3
in
Monaco. What a job.
Let's fucking go,
man! He might as well just come in front of Ricardo and just do this dance. Like,
may as well. He may as well.
Yeah. Poor thing. I'm feeling really bad for Daniel Ricardo. Two episodes and already, I haven't seen last year's Formula One season. I missed it. But it feels like this show is the best way to catch up with it.
100%.
And especially if you're a Formula One fan, you obviously probably know about the show. But even if you're not a Formula One fan, you want to watch this show because the show, while it is about Formula One, it really is about the drivers. And that rivalry is really fun.
The story is great irrespective.
Yeah.
And it's shot beautifully.
Anyway, let us know in the comment section what other awesome Netflix sports related shows you guys are into. I know The Last Dance is another extremely nice sexy show.
Yeah,
you guys can watch that also. On that note, thank you very much, Rohan, Shax. See you very, very soon. Goodbye.